things are always made of the finest ingredients. Just a touch of this, just a touch of that. So how about a touch of France? Let's discover France, French and France in Ghana in a new episode of Touch of France.
Hello, bonjour, welcome, bienvenue to Touch of France, a show that tells you about France and France in Ghana. My name is Anne-Sophie Ave. I am the French ambassador to Ghana and a lover of all things from France and Ghana. Today, we are going to talk about infrastructures, port, transports, railways, roads, all those equipments that are absolutely indispensable for an economy to thrive. And to do so, I am going to go and join someone who is very famous in this country. He became as a miner and eventually has become one of the most successful businessmen in Ghana. I know you know him. I'm going to join Sam Jonah on the field. Follow me.
As a man on a mission, I am constantly on the move. My work takes me to different places from all walks of life. In the process of time, I have met many successful people with different backgrounds and with different drives. One thing has been common among them all. Like me, they don't compromise on quality. Which is why, each day as I leave home to face the world, I drive straight to the one place I know I can refuel for the day, because I am assured of quality fuel at an affordable price.
Numa! Oga dem bawa sabi chalo. Mucha triple S.
Triple S no your dang.
Make them tell you. Factor social distance health.
There at Santor, quality is affordable.
Santor Energy. Clean fuel, friendly service.
Welcome back on Touch of France. Thank you for being with us. I am sitting here with Sir Samuel Esson Jonah. Thank you so much, sir, for having us in your house.
Thank you.
Thank you. So the conversation today, of course, will be about France, about Ghana, but every week we have a theme, and this week we were about to talk about infrastructure and how they are the blood network of economy. I also very briefly introduced you, but it was always too summarized. You began as a miner and you went all the way to being the most successful businessman. But how would you introduce yourself to someone, if there is anyone, who doesn't know you?
I'm Sam Jonah.
Yes.
Came from a pretty humble beginnings. I trained as an engineer, mining engineering. And I did mining engineering because I saw an opportunity that others were not seeing, and therefore
so
I chose.
You mean when you started, there were not many people.
No, there were not.
In this area.
There were not Ghanaians who were engineers who were going into mining. So I saw that that was an opportunity, and I chose the line of least resistance because everybody else was going there. I decided to go there.
Of course.
So I trained as an engineer, and then I later on went into management. I went to business school, and then I came up the rank in the organization. There's no rank on the ladder that I did not occupy. And I was the first Ghanaian to do so. So at the age of 36, I became the head of, at that time, West Africa's biggest company. I took the company from a private company to a listing in London in 1992. In 1996, we became the first African company to list on the New York Stock Exchange. And then 2000, we orchestrated a merger of us and a company called Anglo Gold and became the second largest gold mining company in the world. And I had to move to South Africa, where the company was based, to become the executive president to run it. I took an early retirement, and I've been playing golf since.
Early retirement?
I took an early retirement in 2006.
It seems to me you're still working.
Yes, I'm still working, but not for the corporate. I've been a serial director of companies worldwide. I'm the chairman of about four companies, one in the States, two in Canada, one in London, and they're also directorships of a number of companies. Yes, plus I do a lot of charity work, and I play golf.
You are indeed an inspiration for many, many Ghanaians who think that probably they could have a career like yours. You mentioned that one of the key things was to go where people didn't go and to sort of feel there's something to be done. What other secrets or what other advice could you give to people who would like to look at a career like yours? Don't do like the others?
Yes, first of all, don't be a populist. Don't go because everybody else is going in any direction, you go to that direction. Be creative, be innovative. Look out for opportunities where others don't obviously see. And be focused. Because if you are lacking in focus, as the Americans would say, if you don't know where you are going, any road will take you there. Mm. So decide on where you are going to go and focus on making sure that you acquire all the skill sets which are necessary for you to get to the end of where you want to go to.
Thank you. That's amazing.
And that calls for an awful lot of discipline.
Yes.
In the end, as the famous French philosopher said, luck favors the prepared mind. Yes. You need a lot of luck. Mm-hmm. But if you are prepared, then the luck will just cushion you to the next level.
It was Blaise Pascal.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Do you know how to say it in French?
No.
Le hasard arrive à ceux qui y sont préparés.
Well, I've had a very interesting relationship with the language, you know, your French language. It's not been a very friendly relationship.
Oh, really? You
know? Yeah.
I try and make it friendly.
So I've tried very hard, but the French language doesn't like me, even though I like it.
Oh,
but yes, that's
I'm sure you know more than you say. So I wanted to share with you what France is doing in the area of roads, infrastructures, and yes, indeed, we need to be focused to take the right road, but we also need to have good roads somehow. So I propose that we watch together what we do in France, and then we carry on this conversation.
Fantastic.
Historically, the French government's intervention in the port industry has always been important because of the maritime and military power they represent. In France, the 11 biggest seaports are under the government's supervision and are thus managed by public entities who handle more than 80% of maritime merchandise traffic. The ports of Marseille, Dunkerque, Le Havre, or Bordeaux are one of them. The inland ports of Paris, La Seine, and Strasbourg, Le Rhin, are also managed by the French government. When it comes to passenger transport, France is mostly known for its famous TGV, Train à Grande Vitesse, high-speed train in English. Firstly presented to President Pompidou in March 1974, the TGV began to rally Paris to Lyon, in 1981 at a speed of 260 km per hour. The same year, the TGV reached a record speed of 380 km per hour. Its current speed record is 574.8 km per hour. From Paris, you can take the TGV to Lille, Strasbourg, Marseille, Bordeaux, or even Brussels in Belgium. In France, to move around in the city and avoid traffic jams, you can use public transport such as city buses, the subway or the tram. Faster, cheaper and more environment friendly. The Paris Metro is the oldest subway system in France and was inaugurated at the 1900 Paris Exposition. With the new line, 14.4 million passengers use the Paris Metro every day. Since the COVID-19 crisis, in Paris and in all big French cities, more and more people use the bike to commute. Since the end of the summer 2020 lockdown in France, traffic on bicycle paths has increased by approximately 67% in Paris, 26% in Lille, and 29% on average across the entire country.
Yes, so ports, transports, train. This is very important for us for mobility when we try to reduce the impact of pollution. So what's your take on what we just saw?
I mean, quite exemplary. I mean, your transport system, very well known, very well appreciated. It's certainly world class. The important lessons we can learn from here, what you're doing. I mean, I would say that the first point of call would be to decongest Accra. Any number of systems, transportation systems, mm-hmm. which would let Accra be decongested would help the economy of this country, because the economy is Accra, really. Mm-hmm. And to move from one spot to another, I can take you a couple of hours, and you don't mm-hmm. need that in an efficient economy. Mm-hmm. I'm delighted that there is actually a French company called Puma. It's the world's biggest cable car, I think, manufacturers or so. And they've teamed up with a French engineering company, mm-hmm. and they are putting proposals to government about cable car installation in Ghana, in Accra. That will help decongest in a very mm-hmm. big way. As for the port, you're already doing something there. Bolloré is here.
Yes, Bolloré is here.
And it offers a model of how private sector can come with finance and, mm-hmm. and help, you know, get infrastructure going and recover their money. It's a fantastic opportunity. If Ghana is really to become the hub, we should learn from the French in a very big way. I mean, look, lake transport, mm-hmm. River transport between Accra and the north mm-hmm. to open up, if you're going to be the hub, to open up the north to the landlord countries, you would have to go by way. You can't go by road. You can't.
So okay. You think we could develop the river
absolutely,
transport?
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. I mean, railway is a very important part, uh-huh. component of this whole transport ecosystem. But realistically, in the short term, uh-huh. even though they're trying to do something, to go for what you have, fast trains and all of that, uh-huh. that would take a lot of investment.
But I've seen some very, well, not very old, but some pictures from the 1960s, and there used to be a train there used to be trains in Ghana, there used to be buses, you would still have bus stops. So what happened?
I think that, like everything else, I mean, I think that less emphasis and attention was paid to that. Mm-hmm. And the rail system was largely structured on having a connection between the economic producing activities. Mm-hmm. For instance, they were to link the mines mm-hmm. and to link the timber sector and to link the cocoa sector mm-hmm. because they, by the very nature, the mines required capital, goods and equipment, which can't come by road, and so they were. So they linked Obuasi to Takoradi mm-hmm. to Kumasi to Takwa, and it was essentially for that. If you take Accra, it was almost the same. Mm-hmm. So once the mines started going down, once timber started going mm-hmm. down in terms of production, then it became difficult to sustain the rail system, because you can't build your rail just on passenger.
Yes.
Okay, you've got to have the goods to go with it. And I suspect that plus maybe other aspects of our economic life that we have not looked after too well. That's what had led to the decline. But over the last 6-5 years, the government has started initiating mm-hmm. steps to rehabilitating mm-hmm. the rail sector. I just wish that we would have gone for something more modern in terms of gauge and the cars. But it's an important step mm-hmm. forward. And if you succeed, that will help. But I mean, I think that the dream would be, for instance, to have an underground system.
Really?
Yeah, that would be my dream. I mean, you know, because look at Accra. I mean, Accra is not quite. And then, of course, you have a fast train system network, which will link Accra, Kumasi, uh-huh. Kumasi, Tamale, Accra, Takoradi, Accra, Lome.
What's the distance between Accra and Kumasi?
Oh, it's not a lot. I mean, and I don't think it's, I don't want to guess, but I suspect about 300 kilometers.
300 kilometers?
Yeah.
So and it's more or less the same distance as Paris to Bordeaux?
Yeah. And you can do halfway, Accra halfway. To Kumasi. When you fly.
It could be an hour with a fast train.
Absolutely. I mean, when you fly, which I do.
It is 40 minutes.
It's 40 minutes.
40 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, and yet you can be on the road for 4 or 5 hours.
Yes, that's
but
right.
But more to the point, because Kumasi, the link, Accra to Kumasi and beyond, it's really the food-growing areas of Ghana. Can you imagine what would happen if you had fast road
yes.
network, you know, four lanes and all of that? Food prices will collapse, inflation will come down, and we will see real productivity going forward.
So that really is a dream, but it's
oh, it's a dream. I continue to dream about it. I will continue.
But you know, we have a Ghanaian who is in France and who wanted to tell us about his experience of France and of transport. His name is Jason Aka Mensa Edua. So let's see what he has to say, and we are back.
Wonderful.
My name is Jason Aka Mensa. I arrived in France on the 20th of November, 2020. I'm a student in high school. I'm in high school, so I study general subjects like math, French, science, and all those other subjects. And I chose to come here because my mom lives here. I like the Bugatti. People think that the Bugatti is Italian, but it's actually French. I like it because of the design of it, and it's also very elegant. Yeah, I use public transport in France. The bus, the train, the metro, the tram, I use all of them. And they're very organized, timely, and the passengers have a clear idea of the schedule. So when a public transport is gonna arrive and when it's gonna depart, and you also get a pass, you can get a pass up to a year that you use on each of the public transport, so you don't need to buy a ticket each time you need to go. Yeah, I speak a bit of French. You just need to read books in French, listen to French music and French audios, and watch French TV, and have conversations with people in the language, and you'll be able to get it. Bonjour tout le monde. J'espère vous allez bien. A bientôt.
So that's an example of someone who is using the public transport to go to school, or and it's actually quite safe and timely.
Yeah.
But we know, in France, when the train is just 5 minutes late, people are complaining, and you even if it's 1 hour late, you get paid back. So we really have this quality of service. So you yourself, you have been to France?
A couple of times.
Where exactly? Paris, I guess?
Paris, mainly.
Mainly?
Mainly.
So what did you like in France?
Well, I love the French. I love France. The level of organization of the country is impressive. In terms of the cuisine, hey, who doesn't like French cuisine?
What's your
favorite dish? I love your crepe.
The crepe?
Yeah.
Oh, we showed the recipe of crepes in Touch of France. Okay, I can't remember which episode, but we did already. Okay.
But I love French cuisine, so I kind of move from one restaurant to another. I can't tell you what the restaurants are, but I love space. And so your boulevard, you know, the fact that we haven't trained in the UK, where if you see London roads, you know, I mean, they are that narrow, it's not funny. And then, but you go to France and you see these wide roads and all of that. I mean, it's brilliant. I mean, I love it. I love the culture, you know, I love the sophistication, of France. If you go to the various museums, you know, the wonderful museums, as I said, your there's so much to see in France, so much to see and so much to experience.
So I hope we can welcome you in France more often, so you can
I would
see
love
all
to actually
this.
I would love to, COVID permitting.
Absolutely. So I wanted to share with you a recipe that is typical French and it's quite easy to do. Do you cook?
No.
Okay,
I don't want to kill anybody.
Okay. So, well, I don't cook either, but this is a very easy recipe. So maybe your chef could do it for you. This is called the gratin dauphinois, and it is Chef Patrice who tells us in French, but with subtitles, so we can also listen to some French language. Chef Patrice, the gratin dauphinois.
Bonsoir, les amis. Nous voici sur un magnifique coucher de soleil sur Paris. Et voici la Seine.
Nous sommes de retour en cuisine. Nous allons préparer notre gratin dauphinois avec la très belle pomme de terre que nous avons achetée tout à l'heure.
notre pomme de terre, de l'ail, du beurre, de la noix muscade, du sel, du poivre, du lait et de la crème. Nous allons ajouter un petit peu de poivre, du sel et la noix de muscade avec une râpe. Et voilà, au four, 50 minutes. Et voici tout droit sorti du four, notre magnifique gratin dauphinois. Regardez comme il est beau. Bon appétit!
Have you ever tasted this?
No, it looks absolutely delicious. I don't know what it does to your cholesterol level, though, but it looks absolutely delicious.
That's probably the biggest issue. But you know, French cuisine is not light.
I know.
So we have the cassoulet, we have potatoes, so the basics are not light at all.
Sure.
So I don't know how we keep fit, but you know, if you have proper cuisine, just like Ghanaian cuisine, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
Keeping in shape is probably difficult. So let's recover from this, have a very quick commercial break, and we will be back in a second.
MPS Terminal 3 is Africa's new state-of-the-art container terminal at Tema Port. For manufacturers, agro-processors and traders, the new port means business can be done faster. This infrastructure boost will improve Ghana's port handling capacity, connect more trading routes, and oil the engine of growth for the economy, creating greater opportunities across all sectors as Africa's markets merge and become the largest trading bloc globally. MPS, we connect, you thrive.
Welcome back. Thank you for still being with us. I am here with Sam Jonah in his house. Thanks again for having us. And we are discussing how to develop economy through the infrastructures. You've got lots of ideas and dreams about that. And you mentioned the port, which Bolloré, actually in a consortium, has built this Terminal 3. How do you think we could make the most of the port to make Ghana a hub for West Africa?
First of all, as I said, if logistics is a very important ingredient to a successful development of any economy, and the initiative by Bolloré to do the container terminal and provide the funding for it, because that's always been the challenge. You can have all the ideas about projects, but if you can't access capital, then you know it becomes almost impossible to attain the objective. So Bolloré's initiative here is fantastic. We need more of Bolloré's. We need more of private sector involvement. We need more private sector involvement in the construction and management of roads network. And as we mentioned earlier, the river transportation and all of that. Now, if Ghana has become the hub, the region, then there are a number of things which must happen. First of all, we are uniquely located. We are surrounded by French-speaking countries. Even though we are an associate member of your French group, I believe that by now we should become a full membership status. However, what I'm saying is that if for us to take advantage, even that, because you know, if language is a major facilitator. Okay, so we need to learn French in the same way as our our surrounding countries are also learning English. So French ought to be a compulsory part as a second language in all schools. Because it's important, because we are surrounded by French-speaking countries.
That's right.
Yeah, I think we should do
and
that.
And do you think that Ghana has assets in the free trade zone to become maybe a hub that will make the most of that free trade zone? And what does it take to actually become?
Well, as I said, in terms of location, we are uniquely located. Unfortunately, through the efforts of this government, we've been able to get the secretariat of the free trade zone here. But for us to take advantage of it, there are important parameters which we need to work on. First of all, productivity. Okay. Then logistics. Okay. Then cost of capital.
Yes.
Cost of capital is very, very important. And cost of living also is important. I mean, if you want to make sure that you produce here in a manner that a Nigerian importer finds attractive, you ought to understand that you are competing with the whole world. Doesn't matter that you have a free trade zone, because you're competing with China. If you want to buy this and you want to produce it here, you've got to produce it more efficiently in terms of price and quality than will come from China. Otherwise, you may have the secretariat, you may have this fine free trade zone, but you will not be able to realize the value that comes with it. So power, cost of power, as an example. I mean, you can have Dumso up and down when you have factories which are here producing. Okay, so power cost is important. Power reliability is important. Cost of capital is important. Productivity, immensely important. And of course, we talked about infrastructure, logistics, and all of that. Then you are competing. Otherwise, you will not realize the benefit, the full benefit of you being such in such a strategic location.
Well, these are the challenges, but there are assets as well. The location, but also the peaceful, democratic country, which is quite unique in this area.
I mean, you can't understate that. I mean, Ghana is a peaceful country. I mean, to some extent, we are, you know, surrounded by very challenging,
turbulent
environment. And if we make a success of where we are, to rub off on others also, because you become a role model and people, other countries will see that, my God, Ghana can do it. We ought to be able to get our act together. Because if you look at what the West Coast, this sub-region, I mean, we are in turmoil. I mean, look at Burkina Faso, look at Mali, look at Niger, look at, you know, all of these, even Cote d'Ivoire. I mean, so there are challenges. And I think that we ought to be able to, in a sense, harness the remarkable advantages that we have had historically also in making sure Ghana is seen as an important hub for the region.
You mentioned the port of Tema as a point of entry and the possibility of using river transport.
Yes.
That's what we do from Le Havre to Paris. So in this short documentary, we will follow a container ship all the way from Paris to Le Havre to Paris through river transport. Let's watch. So you saw a bit of France and how we use the river transport. And you may wonder, how do I do to go to France? And the question I'm asked very regularly is, how do I do when I want to get a visa? Well, here's the answer.
So you want to travel to France and need a visa. France is part of the Schengen zone. Hence, a visa to France gives you access to travel across all 26 Schengen countries. Never pass through an agency or intermediates. It is a scam. There is only one way to apply for a Schengen visa at the French embassy. There are various visa options. Make sure you submit a complete application. Make sure you have an appointment. Walk-in is not allowed. Do not submit fake documents. It is an offense and could put you on a travel ban. Plan in advance. Do not apply at the last minute.
Yes, france-visas.gouv.fr and nowhere else. And if you want to watch this little documentary and know everything about how to get a visa, you can go onto the website of the French Embassy. You can also go on Touch of France, the YouTube channel, the Facebook page, Instagram, Twitter. You can watch again the episodes. Everything is online. So thanks again for being with us.
Thank you.
You mentioned earlier the port of Tema, Bolloré, and what the French do. But what do you think the French could also contribute to when it comes to ports infrastructure? What kind of, you mentioned some knowledge or examples that we could have. What would be the most urgent, you think, if you have one thing to put together now, what would be the most urgent? This decongestion of Accra, or is it a fast train to Kumasi, or is it...
Without a doubt, decongestion of Accra.
That's the most important.
Yeah.
And so would you look at underground or tram?
Yes, as
or?
I said, we look massively. I'm told that there's a group that is looking at cable technology or trams. Yeah. So that, but there's absolutely no reason why we can't go for trams.
Mm-hmm.
There's absolutely no reason we can't.
That's electric, I mean, so
yeah.
It's very environmentally friendly.
It's good environmentally, it's friendlier. You go to Paris and you know, it's the ease to move around.
Mm-hmm.
It's brilliant.
You don't need a car in Paris.
You don't need a car to be driving around. So if the public transport system works, and they used to work when I was a kid, I mean, we all used to use public transport. I mean, my father, if he went to Takoradi, his car would be on the train.
Oh.
And then when they get to Takoradi, then the driver will take the car off and then use it in a car. When they're coming back, they put it on the train. I mean, we've had all of that. We had a blue train service.
Really?
Which, you know, you had dinner served, you had a sleeping bed. We've had all of those things together in the past. But there is a desire, there's a quest to revive them.
Uh-huh.
And what is desperately needed is private sector active involvement.
Mm-hmm.
And what private sector will bring, as Bolloré has, mm-hmm. is capital
mm-hmm.
and management.
Okay.
And if you can have that teaming up with government, mm-hmm. then I think that you see quite an improvement in the efficiency levels all across the board.
Message received. Mm-hmm. So here's what we do here as France in Ghana, what our companies do. And this is what I'm going to show you, that is France in Ghana.
Ghana's main port is Tema's. It handles nearly 85% of the goods entering Ghana, of which 45% is container transit. The Tema port concession started in 2004 for an initial 20-year term and got extended to 35 years in 2015. This operation was launched in 2002 by the sector's regulator, the Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, GPHA. Meridian Port Services is in charge of managing the port. It is a consortium made up of the GPHA and Meridian Port Holdings Limited, which equally includes France's Bolloré Transport and Logistics and APM Terminals, the Dutch subsidiary of the Danish company Maersk. This project represents one of French company Bolloré's largest port concessions in Africa, with a total investment of $1.5 billion. Part of the financing comes from the World Bank Group's International Finance Corporation to the tune of $195 million. This expansion from 1.2 million 20-foot equivalent units to 2 million 20-foot equivalent units will reduce transit costs by 25 to 32%. Meanwhile, l'Agence Française de Développement, AFD, is involved in the development of roads infrastructure in Kumasi. The French Development Agency is working on the upgrade of a 2-kilometer section of Lake Road and another 2-kilometer section of the downstream portion of the Ababo drain. The project, financed with a €37.5 million sovereign loan from the French government, will not only reduce commuting time but also the frequency, magnitude, and impacts of flooding. Between 2010 and 2015, AFD conducted a project which includes the rehabilitation and widening of the 15-kilometer road from Awushi to Pokwasi with the help of the African Development Bank. An estimated 100,000 are benefiting from these upgrades. In Accra and Kumasi, AFD supports the management of urban transport. AFD is thus financing the creation of urban passenger transport units in each of the districts of Accra, as well as the creation of a coordination structure, the Greater Accra Passenger Transport Executive. The agency is also working on the main roads and intersections to improve and fluidize traffic, the installation of traffic lights, the development of road interchanges, the construction of bus stops, and the covering of drainage systems are also part of the work undertaken under this project. This project is financed with a €20 million sovereign loan from the French government. And what other Ghanaian-owned oil company but Santos Energy to fuel heavy trucks and other vehicles to ride on these roads?
I saw your reactions. So what's your take on this?
Very impressive. Very impressive. I mean, to put a consortium like this together, that is what we need. And I'm delighted that some of the usual suspects are there, IFC, MESC, all of them.
That's right.
You know, Bolloré, of course. So we need more of such consortium. Mm-hmm. And, I'm just hoping that we will continue to build on the peaceful environment and progressive environment that we have. And that is the only way you can attract much needed capital, because we are in competition with the rest of the world for capital. And capital is nomadic to go to where the greener pastures are. And we're going to create the greener pastures here so that capital will come. Yeah.
Thank you. You mentioned you are surrounded by French country. You mentioned like France. So what's your French language like? Do you speak French?
I have had a very difficult relationship with the language.
Uh-huh.
Language. I've tried. It's a very unfriendly relationship. I've tried many times.
Why do you find it difficult?
I learned French in secondary school, and I wasn't great at it. I passed my French, but unfortunately, as I said, I've never been confident. I've always said that I would go back and learn, but I've got a lot on my plate, so. I get by. I don't speak the language at all. I don't. No, I wouldn't.
Because you're shy, or is it because you don't trust yourself?
I don't think I give it the attention that it deserves.
Uh-huh. Focus again.
Yes, focus again. And, you know, I was a math student. I was an engineering student. And I just wish that I had given it, because some of my colleagues, spoke excellent French. So there's no reason why I couldn't. Uh-huh. But maybe the interest wasn't as there, and I didn't give it the passion. Uh-huh. And you need passion.
You do. That you want you to do. Well, French is the language of love, so I cannot suggest you find...
I mean, that's why the language, the only sentence I remember is "je t'aime."
Really? Yeah, oh, but that's very useful. Yeah. So that's the one you learned.
I found it very, very useful.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I learned it in Tree as well. Medo.
Medo.
Medo. So, well, I'm sure you know a bit of French, because we have so many words that are actually the same in French and English, like metro would be...
Metro would be... Metro?
Metro. Train would be...
I know train. Oh, dear. Train?
Train? Yeah. Absolutely. platform would be quai.
Quai.
Yeah. To travel, it's a bit different from
voyager.
See, I'm so impressed. And a harbor.
Harbor is harbor.
Actually, the other word in English for harbor is
port. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So port.
Port. Okay.
Port. Okay. Do you know how to say a car?
I think I do, but just a senior moment. Car is the vehicle.
Vehicle. Yeah, well, actually, I asked the same question to Stone Boy, and his answer was hilarious. He said, "I remember it sounds like vulture." And it is voiture. And I say, what's the link between vulture and car? But that's way he remembered. Yeah, yeah. So voiture, but yeah, véhicule, yeah. That's right, vehicle. Yeah. You can say véhicule, that's absolutely right. So I'll stop torturing you, because at least a few words you know are already very useful if you go to France. Yeah. And I would be very, very happy to welcome you to France, to show you around and teach you a bit of French.
Merci beaucoup.
Oh, si! Thank you. Thank you very much. And you'll teach me a bit of tree, but I reckon I'm quite hopeless in that respect. So I want to thank you again so very much for sharing with us, for sharing your thoughts, for inspiring generations and people who want to be like you and be successful like you. Ghana has amazing talents, and it takes focus and creativity to become the new Sam Jonah. And we can only wish that in Ghana we've got many, many of those open-minded. But you never forgot to be a golden heart, I can tell. I know I've been very lucky to have you as a friend. And you never forgot how to have friends, how to be good to people. And I think that's also one of the key of your success.
Thank you very much for having me. I think that this is a remarkable initiative. I mean, it goes beyond what we have generally associated with diplomats. And I think to have this platform which you've created opens your country up for us, and it gives us a broader appreciation, gives us the opportunity to broadly appreciate the tremendous opportunities that we can get working in close partnership with France and its partners.
Thank you. Thank you so very much.
Thank you.
So I will now leave you. Thank you again for having me in your house. I will dash back to the studio because we have in this show a music segment, and I welcome to the studio some French artists that I want to share, but you will see when you watch us. And of course, the quiz. Dear viewers, I know you're expecting the quiz, but we will have that in studio later. I will say thank you again to Sam Jonah, and goodbye, but thanks a million for having us.
Most welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us too.
Thank you. Special sequence about music. Please let me welcome the one who invented the French rap. He was born in Congo Brazzaville, grew up in France. He's famous in the entire francophone world for a creative rap. He calls the rap a street journalism. I'll ask him about that. It's an honor to welcome here in Ghana, but listen to this.
Biso, 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 biso l'ambition c'était le grand Wandou. Lacoste et Rehaul, dérangez pas surtout. 100% Congo, Weston, Croco. Les coucounes comme Rocco, il est escroqué l'ego.
Classy, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Where was that shot?
Peace on the Beast, it was my Congolese band. It's a mix between Congolese music and French hip hop. It was the beginning for the French artist to mix hip hop and African music.
Am I right if I say that you introduced rap in France?
Yeah, we have a band whose name Sector A. My first group was hardcore. At this time we need to talk about what happened around us, about the situation of the city in France, of the world.
Where you grew up?
Yeah, it was Minister Amir who was, we want to ask to the world what happened, you know.
Describing the society and being rough on that. Yeah. And then you did one that was a huge success about television, right?
Yeah, it was my first single with my solo career. It was Je Zappe, Je Mate.
Oh yeah, so after the group you went solo. So let's have a look at what it was like.
Mon prix dans le jeu. La 3, la 4, je zappe et je mate.
La 5, la 6,
en sont les complices.
Beaucoup d'argent, de guerre et de sexe à la télé.
La 1, la 2, mon prix dans le jeu.
La 3, la 4,
je zappe et je mate.
La 5,
so that's amazing. But dare I ask you, what are you doing in Ghana?
It's the first time for me in Ghana. And I have a Ghana friend. I work with him. He's a fantastic photographer. His name is Andrew Kumi. And he always talking about crap. Passy, you go in here, you go here. You have to come in Ghana. Ghana is beautiful. He's wonderful. He's Ghanaian. He's wonderful, wonderful. And I was waiting. We do a lot of video clip with him. And I meet an artist whose name is Orte, who is doing Afro pop music.
Amazing.
And I say, oh, this guy is amazing. I have to work on this project. I produce this project and I say, Andrew, I have the project to go.
So now you've got a good reason to go to Ghana.
Yeah. And when Andrew listened, he said, wow, it's amazing. I want to work in this project with him. And
But I understand that you have not lost any time when you were in Ghana and you actually just on the spot recorded something with Kwabna Kwabna.
Yeah, we just have 10 days and we have to meet a lot of people to contract two or three things with Empire. We have to work with Empire, with Volare. We have to work to present this new artist, and we are really.
And in between, you had like 3 hours, and you did this. Let's listen.
Total pour Miss Africa, si. Ambiance locale, vida loca. Belle, claire ou café mocha. Y'a des sexy mamas, tous ferment la boca. International sans Paris Accra. Un son pour les clubs, une douille pour l'Aca. Inséparable comme bulle dans coca. Poisson dans le bocal, bisolino et coca.
That is going to be a huge success. I can tell. That woke me up this morning, and I thought, and it's not edited yet.
Yeah.
It's just rough material.
Yeah, it's a rough mix. Yeah, so, we have to finish it. We do it yesterday night.
Crazy. I heard this verse this morning. Can you imagine, viewers? You're listening something that's not even a record. It's not even out. It's just a rough material, and you've witnessed that. Yeah. I really hope there's success because we've got both French and tree and a bit of English. So that might bring some French to the Ghanaians. And hopefully, if it's a success in France, that will bring tree in France, where some Ghanaian artists are already quite a success. So you mentioned Orti.
Mm-hmm.
So he's an artist that you're producing. Mm-hmm. Did you bring some of his tunes that we could listen to? Can we have a sip of it?
You can discover, there is one whose name 2020.
2020.
And the other one is named Melissa.
Okay, let's have a sip of 2020. See what's like.
Yo, yo, yo. Money, money, plenty, plenty. My music on a 2020. I'll they go fight on the way. I'll be get to peaking. See the road rocking, rocking awesome. I blow the smoke on the water fire. I'll they go fight on the way. I'll be get to peaking.
Accra, how you feeling?
I'll be get to peaking.
All right, Addis. Listen.
Ubuene yo, wami fuo wona. Nadu, nadu, bad things. Ubuodo, epona fuo wona.
Pretty
artist, Nigerian Pidgin?
Yeah, in the Arty album, you can find Yoruba, Pidgin, Igbo, and he's working tree.
He's now working on tree?
Yeah, he's working on tree. And because he loves Africa music, African culture, and he always, it's why I produced this album, he's always want to give love, to sing in Africa, to meet artists from here. He's, you know, he want to give love to our African culture, and we are here now. I think he will do it.
I can very easily understand how you can fall in love with the African culture. Mm. I can witness that too. So you mentioned Melissa.
Yeah, Melissa, it's
so
a lovely one.
Can I have a sip of Melissa?
Yeah, it's a lovely one for African.
Don't be like this. Melissa, don't be like this. I wanna love you. Don't be like this. Melissa, don't be like this.
All right.
She don't know really what she want, but she did call me on the phone. Everything is clear in my mind. Baby, I don't go back for love. And me, I get so many things. Many things we are the team. And he get many, many things. Plenty things where them under the team. She the one Versace, Prada, Gucci, Ape, no me Wincho.
It's quite incredible. I've heard it twice. I've already got it in my head. It's not leaving. So what is that like, this guy look like? Has he got African roots, African origin?
It's why I become mad when I meet this guy, because I produce a lot of artists from Africa, from Senegal, with Bisson, everywhere from the Congo. And with Orti, it's different, because it's a French guy, white guy,
who is love in
African culture. Who learned to speak, he worked with a Nigerian group and he become love.
Nigerian
group and he become love and he began to speak Yoruba, to sing, to listen. And now the project is ready.
So do you think he would join us so we can have it? Actually, I can't believe that a white guy thinks with Pidgin.
Yeah,
Orti, here. Are you around? Can you join us?
Orti.
Oh, you are kidding. You look super white, super French. You look nothing African. So I guess your blood is African.
I don't know. Me no know.
Me no know.
Me no know, I would say.
Okay. You are incredible.
How are you?
This is I'm so amazed. Welcome. Welcome to Ghana. Welcome to Dutch for France. Thank you so much for giving us this exclusivity of avant-première of this tune. No one's heard it yet, has
it? It's a kind of, it's not released yet. So
it's the very first day anyone hears it.
Exactly.
Wow. By the time this show is aired, I'm sure it has become a success, but I will still brag, time code it, and say we were the first. That's amazing. How come did you fall in love with Africa?
Oh, it's a long story. Where we live in France, it's very multicultural. So
multicultural.
We grew up with many different people. People from Senegal, from Congo, from Algeria, everywhere. And we grew up all together.
So, and that's how...
So where we got...
So all these influences, African music...
Exactly, exactly.
And how did you two meet?
I decided 2 years ago to start this project because I used to work with Nigerian people around. I spent time with them, maybe 2 years with them in 2010. And I realized an album for a singer.
And
I learned. So I give, but I receive too. So okay. I begin to learn.
That's where you learned the Nigerian pidgin.
Exactly.
Which is so impressive. I mean, when I heard the song, I thought, this must be a Nigerian.
Yeah.
And the voice as well, when he sings, sounds Nigerian.
Yeah, I think my influence is...
It's just incredible. I can only wish you the best of luck with tune.
Thank you
too, because you're obviously the producer. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, Madame Ambassador.
Thanks a lot, Madame Ambassador.
And I hope to see you
And we are
again.
Very glad to be there. And hopefully, we see very soon.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Don't go, we'll have a quick commercial break, and then we'll come back for the quiz.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back. This is Touch of France, and now a touch of French. This is the moment you have been waiting for, the moment of the quiz. Today's quiz is about something related to transports and infrastructures. So I'm going to ask you a question. You've got three options. If you think you've got the right answer, you dial 1, 3, 2, or 3 at 1788. You dial 1, 2, or 3 at 1788. Okay, here's the question. What is the French word for crane? What is the French word for crane? Is it crâne? Option one. Is it tour? Option two, tour. Or is it grue? Option three, grue. 1, 2, or 3 at 1788. What is the French word for crane? And today, if you get the right answer and you're the first to give the right answer, the fastest, you are getting a dinner or two at Le Tandem, French restaurant in Accra. It is now time for me to say goodbye, because this episode is coming to an end, and of course to thank our partners. I want to say thank you to Santol, Decathlon, Bolloré, Sirene Insurance, Tract Afrique, Orca Deco, Société Générale, Silverstar, Peugeot and Citroën, MPS, the AFD, the team of the French Embassy and the production, and all of those who have made it possible to put together this episode of this show, Touch of France. As for me, I say bonne semaine, have a nice week. Merci beaucoup, au revoir, thank you very much, bye-bye.
On va bouger le monde, on va bouger le monde. It's the touch of France in your household. It's the touch of France in your mind. It's the time for Ghana to make a big step. It's the time to dance to the vibe. If you know what it is, then you know what I mean. From Accra to Paris, it's how you gonna feel. It's what you wanna see, it's what you wanna feel. It's where you gonna be, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's the touch of France from Ghana.